Sani Togozani, welcome to Learning with Noma, your online comprehensive classroom where we are changing our lives one lesson at a time. I am Gog Noma, and this is your home of spiritual learning and healing. Do not forget, if you have not subscribed yet to the classroom, click the subscribe button, leave the notification bell on so that each time a lesson is loaded in the classroom, you are notified. In this classroom, the lesson that is learned or a lesson learned should be a lesson shared. So click the share button. Do not be afraid to share, share, share. Let us learn together. Let us grow together. Today's lesson, Impepho or the Helichrysum. So yes, there's about 600 species worldwide and 250 species of impepho around South Africa. And today I'm just going to be talking about the different uses of impepho and how we can sort of like administer the different mode of administration that we can use impepho for. Impepho is an African herb that can be used by anybody. There's a question that I got on TikTok to say, Gogo, if I have not gone through the process of intwaso, can I drink impepho? Can I even use impepho? Yes, it's an African healing herb and it can be used by anybody, obviously with the right intention set and you understanding the herb in itself, then you can use it. So I'm going to start by the most commonly used mode of administration for impepho, being the burning or the smoking of or the smoke that is used from impepho. And with this way of using impepho, traditionally in the olden days you would find that there is a person who is dedicated in the family, an elder, malume, tatemogolo, who will be allocated to be the one otlochisa impepho, the one also shisa impepho during rituals, the one who will burn the incense when there are rituals or when there's need for the family to communicate with the ancestors during the rituals of ukuphahla. Unfortunately, with religion and shift from traditional ways, we find ourselves not in that situation anymore, where we as young generation are caught up in situations where you have to pahla for yourself, where your ancestors are communicating or even reaching out to you, and there's no elder in the family who's willing to support or who even has the knowledge of how do we communicate, how do we burn impepho, why do we burn impepho. And please let me also emphasize that not every culture or not everybody or not every dlozi will require you to burn impepho to communicate. Please watch, the link is in the description below. There is a lesson I did on ukuphahla about tools of ukuphahla or tools to pahla, and impepho is also discussed a little bit in terms of using it when you pahla and burning it as an incense to invite the air element with the smoke of impepho. So you can burn it. As we know, when you burn it, it is used mostly to invoke ancestors or to invoke spirit. It is used to cleanse energies or spirits that are not serving your space. So you can use it to cleanse the rooms or even your house, moving from one room to another. It is also very good to repel incense. So when you have insect problems, you can use impepho. Some people even plant it to help to have it the same as you would use with your mint. So yes, impepho, when you burn it, it can be used to invoke your ancestors as you pahla, you know, as a way of saying gilana, the weather smoke, there's fire. So abantu badala, they would come and see that you are now tokozisani abantu badala, and you are inviting them to come into your space. It is also very good when somebody is suffering from tension headaches, and this can be both in drinking and also when you are just inhaling the smoke of impepho. And mostly again, in our traditional healing spaces, you will find that when one is going to have drums beaten for them or spirit needs to be invoked, impepho will be burnt. We also use impepho, especially now with COVID, in most Ndumbas, you will find abogogo nabomkhulu burning impepho to cleanse their spaces between patients, even the bag of inkolo, you will find them using impepho just to smudge the bag in between patients, and that is the burning of impepho using the smoke. When again we talk about impepho, we look at using impepho for steaming and for bathing or for bathing, for cleansing. So when you are steaming with impepho, it helps with, just besides the spirituality or the spiritual indication of uvulikhanda nokuvuli, as we say, uvulikhanda nokuvuli sifuba, we can come to the medical side of it to say it helps with decongestion. So when you have bronchial congestion or even sinusitis and you're congested with your sinuses, it helps to drain the mucus. So you can use it to steam, because steaming is the same as you taking, what can I say, a nebulizer. It's the same as you being nebulized. The whole purpose of one being nebulized is to loosen the mucus so that it can drain, and by it draining, then you can feel much better, you can breathe better, you can sort of like cough up the mucus better, and it can be removed from your lungs and you can breathe better. So with steaming, it also helps, as because it has antioxidant properties. So as you steam and you're sweating, you're sort of like detoxing your system, but in at a deeper level, because it's not just a physical detox, but we're also cleansing spiritually. That is impepho. And again, in many cultures, you're gonna find that when a baby is born, as a measure of protecting the baby, impepho will be used in the water to sort of to bath the baby for them to be protected. So to as they are growing up, and also in the introduction of a child. So with the burning also, I will go back and forth with all the methods, but mainly again, you know, with when we burn, remember I said that it will be upahla, and upahla has many intentions. It can be ubiga, to introduce to abantu abadala something, ukushweleza, to ask for forgiveness for something. It can be also just to come and announce that this is what is happening. So there'll be different intentions, but basically impepho will be used for such. And then we find that we also find products of impepho, mainly being the oil that is so commonly found today. There's lots of impepho oil that we find, and impepho soap. So there are products that are being, you know, that we find now from the impepho itself. And I'm just gonna say to you, it's basically with the oil mainly. You find that it is very good to be used on the skin because of the anti-aging properties in impepho. So it helps with wrinkles. Most people use it on their faces for acne, and you find that their skins are smooth like babies. And even with the impepho soap, when you use it together with the impepho oil, again depending on the sensitivity of your skin. And while I'm there, please note that if you have any allergies to sunflower, as impepho is part of the sunflower family, you need to be very careful when you're using impepho. Remember, it's got those golden yellow flowers. Those are sunflowers family, sort of like plants. So it's got properties of sunflower, and if you're allergic to it, you might find yourself having an allergic reaction. So please be very careful when you're using the impepho, especially on your skin when you've got the allergies to sunflower. So when you are using it on the skin, it is good for wound healing. You will find that most of the time it is used as medicine on wounds. So it will be put in water and the wound will be washed with impepho, and sometimes even impepho dressings will be done, where the plant itself can be put on the wound, a dressing done, maybe changed daily, or even changed, you know, in 2 days, depending on how the wound is and what kind of product is used. It can be the oil or it can be the impepho as a plant itself. It really helps with cell rejuvenation, hence wound healing and skin care. It's one of those properties that impepho has. And if you steam with it also, you are getting the natural, you know, the natural properties, and you will find that it really helps with skin problems. So we use it when we are having wounds, and it helps a lot with wound healing. And then impepho, again, you can, which is what most people were asking for me to even do this lesson, impepho tea, known as the dream tea, where you can boil it in a pot with water. And you know, in the olden days, Abantabadala, they would put tea bag in the teapot and they would boil the water and want it to be very strong. Otherwise, you can actually take the impepho leaves and you just pour hot water, boiling water, let me say boiling water, to allow it, and then to allow it to sort of like make the tea, and you drink that. Preferably for me, without any sugar. Rather have just you know, a spoon of honey in there, even half a spoon of honey. But I don't really advise on like your sugar grains. Rather have honey, or just drink it as it is. So when you are drinking impepho is also good again for chest problems or respiratory problems. When you've got your mucus, it can help loosen the mucus. When you're drinking it, it's got sedative properties. So when you're suffering from insomnia, you can have impepho tea before you sleep. It is very good to help you to sleep better, and if you're sleeping better, you can dream better because your body is relaxed. Hence, we say it's a dream tea, because when people drink it, they will tell you that my dreams have become clearer, I'm having vivid dreams, I'm seeing and I'm remembering my dreams better. So you can simply boil your water, put your, you know, a handful maybe of impepho into your teapot, boil it and drink it over time, or you can simply just drink it as a tea. I know there are products that are available as impepho tea where they've actually put it in a tea bag and you can drink it. Other people enjoy drinking it or boiling it with milk, which is also another way to drink it, depending on what will work for you. And again, impepho is very good, or has anti-inflammatory properties. So as you are drinking it, or as you are applying it to your skin, when you are doing your hot compressions, utoba your joints, or even applying it as an oil when you're buying the products, it helps with you know, diseases such as arthritis, so inflammatory diseases. Even when you are having your periods and you're having period pains, it helps a lot for most women when they're experiencing dysmenorrhea and you've got those painful periods. You can drink impepho tea and it helps to soothe the pain. You can also use impepho tea as an antiseptic, as I said, or antifungal on your skin. So if you've got a wound that is really not healing, or that is sort of like looking septic, you can clean the wound with the water that has impepho, and you can also apply a dressing of impepho, being careful that you are not allergic to sunflower. The other precautions that we need to take when we're using impepho, especially if you're someone who's using diuretics, that is tablets that are draining water, that can be your Redux, your Lasix, those kind of tablets, as impepho also has a diuretic effect or properties that are gonna cause you to go to the bathroom and drain water in your body. It is also important for you to remember to increase your fluid intake. If you're not someone who will then drink your 1.5 to 2 liters a day, it is very important to make sure that you have enough fluids, and fluids being water, drinking clear water, because it is going to be excreted through the kidneys. And therefore, you need to remember, as an antioxidant, as it detoxes and flushes the system, the only way the system can be flushed is through excretion of toxins through urine and feces and sweat, and all those are water-based, I'll say, excretion modes. In order for you to go to the bathroom, you know, for number one, you need to have water. Number two, in order for you not to be constipated, you need to have enough water. Even with sweating, it's water that is being lost, or fluids that are being lost in your body. So to prevent dehydration, please drink water. And remember, when you're drinking impepho, like I said, it's a herb, it's medicine. You cannot drink medicine as if you're drinking water. You cannot have 5 cups of Impepho a day. So you need to also remember the dosing. Maybe have 1 cup a day, 2 cups in the morning and in the evening, but always remember to have your fluids. If you're pregnant, I'd even suggest just half a cup because it is one of those herbs that have not really been proven not to be passing through the placenta. And we know when you're pregnant, you still need to think of the life that you're carrying with all its little organs still developing. So be very careful when you are having your Impepho tea when you are pregnant. Rather just take half a cup maybe once a week to help with the cleansing and detoxing and to help with you remembering your dreams. There is so much to cover on Impepho, I know, but I just hope that the little that I've shared today will be enough. Please do leave comments in the comment section, ask your question, and I shall surely attend to. Those who joined me on TikTok know that we did a whole 2 hours where I was really, really unpacking each and everything. But like I always say, those who come on my life are meant to be there for the right reasons at the right time. Unfortunately, the life was not saved by TikTok, therefore, I had to come and do a recording on the lesson. I hope that you found this lesson insightful and that the next time you use Impepho, at least you will understand how you're using it and why you're using it. And if there's any question, please do ask. We have the common Impepho here in South Africa that you will find mostly when you go and you're buying Impepho. Sikhuluma, which is the most common one. When you say I need impepho, this is what you will probably be given. Impepho yasemanzini, we've got impepho yamawele, which is also known as sutha ka Sesotho. And from KZN, impepho yamawele, you're going to find it interwoven like ilugilwe, and then from Lesotho you're going to find it as if like it's a broom, and by ibiza sutha. So those different impepho's are also used for different intentions at different times. And there is more, there is more. They are not just limited to those three that you can find, but I'm just talking about the most common one. And we know when you talk about impepho yamawele, most people will be telling you about ukuzalwa kwembethe, those that were born with their amniotic sac still intact. Yeah, so maybe that will be a part two where we sort of like unpack those different purpose culturally, but right now I was just giving a general understanding of impepho. So you can burn impepho to use it as an incense for the smoke to cleanse your energies, to evoke ancestors, to communicate, and use it as a tool when you partner, when you've got problems of incense infestation. You can use the impepho to steam and bath, and like I said, for babies it's also very good when a newborn is bathed with impepho for protection. But please again, find out culturally or traditionally in your space what is done to protect the baby. And then you can use impepho to drink as impepho tea, known as the dream tea, when you're struggling to sleep, when you're struggling to remember your dreams. But again, remember, when you're using impepho to drink, it's also very important for the cleansing to have happened. So palaza, palaza, uvulisifuba, open your chakras, especially your third eye, because when we palaza, we're sort of like opening up the third eye, the crown chakra, our throat chakra, the heart chakra, the solar plexus, because we're going all the way up. And it's very important for you to do the cleansings before we even start wanting things to shift in our space. So you can futa and bathe with the mbepo, you can palaza, and then start drinking the tea in order for us to say now you can start remembering your dreams. And again, impepho can be used on the skin to help with wound healing, to help with cell rejuvenation as an anti-aging agent, and also to help with acne in our skin. And as I've said, there are products that are available from oils to soap to the tea itself, and you can find those. I'm sure when you search online, abogogo bakhona who are selling their products, who have been called to be, to come and package African medicine in a way that can be applicable to the generation of today. And I'm very proud of all the packaging that we see of our African medicine, the professionalism and the understanding that we are a generation that also needs to evolve, that also needs to develop. So yes, that is Impepho lesson. I hope that you found the lesson insightful. Do not forget to leave your comment in the comment section. Share what you use Impepho for. Share how you prepare your Impepho tea. Share when do you steam with your Impepho. Share what it has done in your space. I am Gog Noma. Until next time, hope that you found this lesson very much insightful. Do not forget to subscribe. Leave the notification bell all on so that you get notified when new lessons are uploaded in the classroom. Share, 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 share in this classroom. A lesson learned should be a lesson shared. This is Learning with Noma. Until next time. Ta-ra-za.